So to begin with, in the last class, we had discussed about some of the properties, right? We had discussed about some of the properties, and this is where we had left. That is, sine inverse x plus cos inverse x is equal to pi by 2. So as I told you earlier, just like the direct trigonometric function has the basic identities. What are the basic identities? 1 plus tan square x is equal to secant square x, 1 plus cot square x is equal to cosecant square x, sine square x plus cos square x is equal to 1. So just like direct trigonometric function has some basic identities, even inverse trigonometric functions also has some identities. Those are these, that is, sine inverse x plus cos inverse x is always pi by 2 if x belongs to minus 1 comma 1. And tan inverse x plus cot inverse x is equal to pi by 2 if x belongs to R. Cosecant inverse x plus secant inverse x is equal to pi by 2. Remember, all these properties we will be applying in some or the other problems. That's why we are going in detail with regarding to the properties. Okay, so the first property out of this, the first one, that is sine inverse x plus cos inverse x is equal to, what you have to prove, it is equal to pi by 2, correct? So what did I say? First we'll take sine inverse x as equal to, sine inverse x is equal to y. Okay, let sine inverse x is equal to y. Then what is sine y? Sine y is equal to x. I hope you know why we have written all these things. So sine y is equal to x. Okay. So now, what did I say? I can write sine in terms of cos also. Sine y in terms of cos of something, correct? Because we know that cos of pi by 2 minus x is equal to sine x. Correct? Huh? Cos of pi by 2 minus x is equal to sine x. Since pi by 2 minus x comes in the first quadrant, and in the first quadrant, cos is also positive. Therefore, we have it is plus sine x. Either. ಈಗ ಇದನ್ನ ಏನ್ ಬರಿಬಹುದು ಸೈನ್ ವೈ ಅನ್ನು ಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪೈ ಬೈ ಟೂ ಮೈನಸ್ ವೈ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪೈ ಬೈ ಟೂ ಮೈನಸ್ ವೈ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಐ ನೀಡ್ ಕಾಸ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಸೊ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ ನಾನು ಎರಡು ಕಡೆ ಕಾಸ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಸ್ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡಿದೆ ಸೊ ಕಾಸ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾಸ್ ಪೈ ಬೈ ಟೂ ಮೈನಸ್ ವೈ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಕಾಸ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ correct? So cos inverse of cos is the element itself. So that is pi by 2 minus y is equal to cos inverse x. Okay. So then what is the next step? Take minus y to the other side. Keep pi by 2 over there. So pi by 2 is equal to cos inverse x plus y. But what was y? Y was sine inverse x. So substitute cos inverse x plus sine inverse x. So, did we get our answer? Cos inverse x plus sine inverse x is equal to pi by 2. Hope now it is clear, students. Subramania and someone with Vivo, you should rename because I cannot call you Vivo again and again. You should rename. Okay. I hope you have understood, Radhika. Yes. Okay, fine. So the second one, the similar thing way you have to take. So take y is equal to tan inverse x. Those who have understood, you can work it out. So y is equal to tan inverse x. So tan y is equal to x. Again, we know that cot of pi by 2 minus x is equal to tan x. So apply that here. So that becomes cot pi by 2 minus y is equal to x. Apply cot inverse both the sides. Okay, apply cot inverse both the sides. So we'll get pi by 2 minus y is equal to cot inverse x. So pi by 2 is equal to cot inverse x plus y. But we know we have taken y as tan inverse x. So pi by 2 is equal to cot inverse x plus tan inverse x. So you can take the third one as your work, like homework. Okay. So we'll move on to the next question. Next property, students. Okay, this is something very, very important. This is, they repeat this question every time. Okay, they repeat this question. I don't know what is there. Such a simple question, but they repeat this in the annual exam every time. Okay, either this or there is one more problem which they repeat. So alternatively, they repeat this. Either tan inverse x plus tan inverse y is equal to tan inverse x plus y, or tan inverse x minus tan inverse y is equal to tan inverse of x minus y divided by 1 plus xy. So they repeat this again and again. Such an easy problem. They repeat it again and again. Okay. Okay, student. So what we have to prove here, what we have to prove, we have to show that we'll take the first one first. Second one is, it follows the first one. So tan inverse x plus tan inverse y is equal to tan inverse of x plus y divided by 1 minus xy. And xy should is always be less than 1. So we have to prove this. How to prove this? Can anyone tell me how to prove this? How to prove this? So, okay, observe carefully, students. This is very important, as I've told you earlier. So, okay. Tan A plus tan B, yeah, we have to use tan A plus tan B form, tan X plus Y formula. Yes, good. See, someone is giving me, some people are giving me answers. Good, students. So, you know what we have to do. So, what we'll do is, let tan inverse X is equal to A. Okay, I'll take tan inverse X is equal to A and tan inverse Y is equal to B. Remember, I have taken tan inverse X as A and tan inverse Y as B. Okay, then what that implies? Tan inverse X is equal to A implies X is equal to tan A, correct? X is equal to tan A, and also that implies Y is equal to tan B. Okay, I hope you understood this. I've taken tan inverse X is equal to A and tan inverse Y is equal to B. So what does that imply? X is equal to tan A and Y is equal to tan B. Now you apply what is tan X plus Y. What is the formula for tan X plus Y, students? What is the formula for tan X plus Y? Those who have understood, you can draw. Work it out. Others, what is the formula for tan X plus Y? Tan X plus Y. What is the formula? Okay, Pallavi has given me the formula. That is tan X plus tan Y divided by 1 minus. Dikshita also has given tan X tan Y. So this is the formula which we had studied in our first PUC, and I hope you people remember this. So tan X plus Y is equal to tan X plus tan Y divided by 1 minus tan X tan Y. Okay, so write the left hand side as it is, tan X plus Y. We know what is tan X. Okay, students, I made a mistake. It should be tan A plus B. Okay, sorry. It is tan A plus B. It should be tan A plus tan B. Tan A 1 minus tan A tan B. Sorry for the inconvenience, students. It should be tan A plus B. Tan A plus B. This is nothing but tan A plus B, students. Okay, so tan A plus B is... So tan A plus B, I have to write. So tan A plus B is tan A plus tan B divided by 1 minus tan A tan B. So I know what is tan A. What is tan A? Tan A is nothing but X plus. What is tan B? Tan B is Y divided by 1 minus X Y. Correct? Because tan A is X, tan B is Y. This is nothing but tan A plus B. Tan A plus B is equal to tan A plus tan B divided by 1 minus tan A into tan B. I have replaced the values, re-substituted. That is, tan A is X, tan B is Y. 1 minus tan A is X into Y. Okay. So now, What did I get? Tan of a plus b is equal to x plus y divided by 1 minus xy. Okay, I need tan inverse of x plus y. I don't need tan here. So what I can take? I can take the inverse both the sides. So if I take the inverse, what happens? It is tan inverse of tan a plus b is equal to tan inverse of x plus y divided by 1 minus xy. Okay, so tan inverse of tan is a plus b is equal to tan inverse of x plus y divided by 1 minus xy. We know what is a. What is a? A is tan inverse x. What is b? B is tan inverse y. So we got our formula. Such an easy question, they ask for 3 marks or sometimes for 2 marks also. Okay, hope this, I hope you have understood. I'll repeat this. Okay, I'll repeat this again. So what we have to start? We have to start with, let A is equal to tan inverse X and B is equal to tan inverse Y. Okay, A is equal to tan inverse X, B is equal to tan inverse Y. That implies X is equal to tan A, Y is equal to tan B. Correct? Then you apply the formula for tan A plus B. What is tan A plus B? It is tan A plus tan B divided by 1 minus tan A tan B. But we know what is tan A. What is tan A? Tan A is X plus Y divided by 1 minus XY. So tan of A plus B is equal to this thing. Take tan inverse both the sides. So you'll be remaining with A plus B is equal to tan inverse of X plus Y divided by 1 minus XY. Substitute the value of A. A is tan inverse X. B is tan inverse Y is equal to tan inverse of X plus Y divided by 1 minus XY. Hope this was clear, students. Hope this was clear. Okay, fine. So now for the second one, what you will do? I hope now you can solve the second one also, right? Second one also, same thing. You just apply tan A minus B formula. Okay, same thing. Okay, take A is equal to tan inverse X, B is equal to tan inverse Y, and then apply tan A minus B formula. You can do that also, or else. Second method, one method hage ide riti hoguvantadu a tan a minus b formula hakuvantadu illvo. What else you can do is idan derive maduvantadu. You derive this thing and just replace y by minus y. Okay, you can do the both the methods. First method is you apply tan a minus b formula, same method, tan a minus b formula you apply. ಓಕೆ ಇಲ್ವೋ ಇದಿಷ್ಟು ಡಿರೈವ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಟ್ಯಾನ್ ಟ್ಯಾನ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಟ್ಯಾನ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಟ್ಯಾನ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ವೈ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ 1 ಮೈನಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಡಿರೈವ್ ಮಾಡಿ. ಮಾಡಿದ ಮೇಲೆ ಎಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲಿ ವೈ ಇದೆ ಅದನ್ನು ಮೈನಸ್ ವೈ ಇಂದ ರಿಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ. ಸೊ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ? ಸೊ ಟ್ಯಾನ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಟ್ಯಾನ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ವೈ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಟ್ಯಾನ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಮೈನಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ 1 plus xy. So what is tan inverse of a negative angle? Tan inverse of minus y is, we had seen this property, tan inverse of minus y is minus tan inverse y. So that is equal to tan inverse of x minus y divided by 1 plus xy. Okay, you can do both the methods. Either you can go in this method, or you first derive tan inverse x plus tan inverse y, then you replace y by minus y. Okay, so we'll move on to the next question. Okay, this is your next question. 2 tan inverse x is equal to 2 tan inverse x is equal to sin inverse of 2x divided by 1 plus x square. So how to prove this? How to prove this? Before starting this, I want you to remember the formula of certain trigonometric angles, that is sine 2x. So sine 2x has many formula, that is 2 sine x cos x. One more formula is in with respect to the tan theta, that is somewhere we use tan x in sine 2x. So the formula goes like sine 2x is equal to 2 tan x divided by 1 plus tan square x. Okay, next one more is cos. For cos 2x also we have some three formulas. One is four formulas: cos square x minus sin square x, 2 cos square x minus 1 minus 2 sin square x. So one more formula was with respect to tan theta, that was 1 minus tan square x divided by 1 plus tan square x. Make a note of this, students. This is important because we use these formula to solve further identities. That's why. Okay, cos 2x is equal to 1 minus tan square x divided by 1 plus tan square x. What is tan 2x then? What is tan 2x? 2 tan x divided by 1 minus tan square x. Make a note of this. These three formulas, sine 2x is equal to, we have many formula for sine, two formulas for sine 2x. One is 2 sine x cos x, one more is 2 tan x divided by 1 plus tan square x. For cos 2x, we have cos square x minus sine square x, 2 cos square x minus 1 minus 2 sine square x, and one more is 1 minus tan square x divided by 1 plus tan square x. And for tan 2x, we have 2 tan x divided by 1 minus tan square x. Now, how to solve this? So what I'll do is, I'll explain one. First one I'll explain. For the second one, you have to give me the answer. Okay. So what I'll do is, let x is equal to tan theta. Okay. Let x is equal to tan theta. Then what happens to theta? Theta is equal to tan inverse x. Do you agree with the students? I've taken x is equal to tan theta. Then you apply tan inverse both the sides. So what you'll get? Tan inverse x is equal to tan inverse of tan theta. So tan inverse of tan theta is theta. So theta is equal to tan inverse x. Okay, theta is equal to tan inverse x. So now you take the RHS. Okay, take the RHS. What is the RHS? RHS is sine inverse of 2x divided by 1 plus x square. Okay, RHS is sine inverse of 2x divided by 1 plus x square. That is sine inverse of, we have value for x. We have taken x is equal to tan theta. Substitute that. What is it? 2 into tan theta divided by 1 plus tan square theta. Correct? I have taken x is equal to tan theta. So wherever I have x, I have to replace it by tan theta. So 2 into x I have. So it becomes 2 into tan theta divided by 1 plus x square I have. It is nothing but 1 plus tan square theta. So that is sine inverse of, what is this? 2 tan theta divided by 1 plus tan square theta. What is this? 2 tan theta sine 2x. Good, Nitya Lakshmi. Here in place of x, we have theta. So it is, good, Subramanian. So it is sine 2 theta. Okay. So Ranjita, Thea, everyone is giving the answer now. So it is sine 2 theta. Correct? You can see the formula over here. It is 2 tan x divided by 1 plus tan square x. Here in place of x, we have theta. So that becomes sine 2 theta. Okay. Okay, fine. So what is sine inverse of sine 2 theta? What is sine inverse of sine 2 theta? Sine inverse of sine 2 theta. What it is? Sine inverse of sine x is x. Here in place of x, we have 2 theta. Yes, good, Dikshita. It is 2 theta. Okay. Sine inverse of sine 2 theta is just 2 theta because we are using this thing which we know already, sine inverse of sine x is always x. Here in place of x we have 2 theta. Good, sir. So it is 2 into theta. But what is theta? What is theta? Theta is tan inverse x. Theta is tan inverse x. But what is 2 tan inverse x? That is our LHS. So we have proved that LHS is equal to RHS. That is, we have proved this property. 2 tan inverse x is equal to sine inverse of 2x divided by 1 plus x square. I hope this was clear. Should I repeat this? Okay, this is clear, right? Okay, fine. So we'll move on to the next one. This one. 2 tan inverse x is equal to cos inverse of 1 minus x square divided by 1 plus x square. So what we have to give the substitution here? What we have to do? We'll solve the second one. For the second one, what should be the substitution? Let x is equal to, what should be the substitution? For the second one, students, 2 tan inverse x is equal to cos inverse of 1 minus x square divided by 1 plus x square. So what should be the substitution for x? What should be the substitution for x? X should be equal to tan theta, not cos theta. It should be tan theta, Nur Fatima. Good idea, it is tan theta. Okay, so if x is equal to tan theta, what happens? We get theta is equal to tan inverse x, correct? Theta is equal to tan inverse x. So then you take the RHS. Take the RHS, that is cos inverse of 1 minus x square divided by 1 plus x square. Replace wherever we have x, replace it by tan theta. So cos inverse of 1 minus x square is tan square theta divided by 1 plus tan square theta. So what is this, what is the term inside the bracket? How can we replace it? Cos inverse of 1 minus tan square theta divided by 1 plus tan square theta can be replaced into cos 2x, correct? But here in place of x we have theta, so it is cos 2 theta. So we had seen the formula, you can see the formula over here, correct? Cos 2x is equal to 1 minus tan square x divided by 1 plus cos square x. So here this can be written as cos 2 theta. So what is cos inverse of cos 2 theta? What is cos inverse of cos 2 theta, students? What is cos inverse of cos 2 theta? 2 theta. Good, Dikshita. Zaiba, good. So it is 2 theta. So it is 2 into, what is theta? Theta is tan inverse x. Tan inverse x. So that is nothing but our LHS. So we have proved that RHS is equal to LHS, that is 2 tan inverse x is equal to cos inverse of 1 minus x square divided by 1 plus x square. Okay, so I think you can do the third one. What should be the substitution for third one, students? What should be the substitution for third one? What should be the substitution for third one? Let x is equal to tan theta, and then you can continue with that. Okay, so let x is equal to tan theta. Try to work it out. Let x is, if you put x is equal to tan theta, so you'll get theta is equal to tan inverse x. Similar procedure, take the RHS. So it is tan inverse of, wherever you have x, replace it by tan theta. It is 2 tan theta divided by 1 minus tan square theta. What is the term inside the bracket can be replaced by? What is the term which can be, we can replace the term inside the bracket by? 2 tan theta by 1 minus tan square theta. 2 tan theta by 1 minus tan square theta. How can we replace it? With what value we can replace tan 2x? Good, students. So it is tan 2 theta. So that is tan inverse of tan 2 theta is 2 theta. So that is 2 into tan inverse x. Correct? So that is what we need. So in total for 2 tan inverse x, we have 3 formulas, or we can use 3 different forms. So one is sin inverse of 2x divided by 1 plus x square. The other one is cos inverse of 1 minus x square divided by 1 plus x square. And the one more is tan inverse of 2x divided by 1 minus x square. And all these formulas you can use only under certain conditions. So the first you can use under mod x less than or equal to 1. Okay. And the second one you can use when x is greater than or equal to 0. And the third you can use when the value of x lies in between open interval minus 1 comma 1. Okay. Fine. Next one. How to show this? And this is also important. Either they ask that or this, that is tan inverse x plus tan inverse y, or they ask this also. So this is very important. I have to. So if you have any doubt, please put it in the chat box, students. Okay. So how to prove this? Sin inverse of 2x. Sin inverse of 2x. For last problem, you can go to the YouTube because I have to solve this. Okay. Sin inverse of 2x into square root of 1 minus x square is equal to 2 sin inverse x. What can be the substitution so that I can get the right hand side? So what should we give as substitution for x? Okay. X is equal to sin theta. Okay. So if you put x is equal to, we'll see. Someone has told me to put x is equal to sin theta. I think Atiya, Dikshita, Subramanya, everyone is telling me to put x is equal to sin theta. So we'll see what we'll get, Swaroop. Okay. So, okay. We'll see. If you put x is equal to sin theta, then what is theta? Theta is equal to sin inverse x. Okay. If x is equal to sin theta, theta is equal to sin inverse x. Should I start with left hand side or right hand side? Should I start with left hand side or right hand side? Those are okay. RHS or left? LHS. Okay. Pallavi, Atiya are telling me to start with LHS. Okay. So if I take LHS, LHS is sin inverse of 2x into square root of 1 minus x square. Okay. So wherever I have x, I have to replace it by sin theta. So 2 sin theta into square root of 1 minus sin square theta. What is 1 minus sin square theta, students? What is 1 minus sin square theta? What is 1 minus sin square theta? Is cos square theta. Good, Pallavi. It is cos square theta. Okay. So 2 sin theta into square root of 1 minus sin square, because we have cos square theta plus sin square theta is equal to 1. Okay, cos square theta plus sin square theta is equal to 1. So 1 minus sin square theta is nothing but cos square theta. Okay, so if I replace, it is cos square theta, cos theta whole square. I can cut the square and square root. So what is remaining? Sin inverse of 2 sin theta cos theta. Sin inverse of 2 sin theta cos theta. What is, how can I replace 2 sin theta cos theta by which angle, or by what I can replace 2 sin theta cos theta? 2 sin theta sin 2x. Good, Nitya Lakshmi. It is nothing but sin 2x. It is not cos 2x. It is sin 2x. What is the formula for sin 2x? It is 2 sin x cos x. So you can see, ilene ide namage 2 sin theta cos theta ide. So that becomes sin inverse of sin 2 theta. What is sin inverse of sin 2 theta? It is 2 theta. So it is 2 into, good Elvina, sin inverse x. So we got the RHS. I hope I was clear. So those who had suggested that is the correct answer. You have to put x is equal to sine theta. So that theta becomes sine inverse x. And we have to start from LHS. So sine inverse of 2x into square root of 1 minus x square. Replace x by sine theta. 1 minus sine square theta is nothing but cos square theta. And that implies 2 sine theta cos theta. This 2 square and square root get cancels. So we'll be left out with 2 sine theta cos theta. That is sine inverse of sine 2 theta. So sine inverse of sine 2 theta is 2 theta, which is equal to 2 sine inverse x. Hope this was clear, students. Hope this was clear. Okay. So we'll move on to the one last question. After that, we'll stop the session. Okay. And this is important, students. This one. Sine inverse of 2x into square root of 1 minus x square is equal to 2 cos inverse x. So here, what should be the substitution and where we have to start with? Okay, already I have the answer. Put x is equal to cos theta. Okay, good Pallavi, good Sahana. Put x, it's not sine theta, it should be cos theta. Good Vaishnavi. Okay, so if I put x is equal to, what will I get? Nani answer cos inverse ali barbeku, correct? Answer cos inverse ali barbeku anta helidre, x ge cos theta anta substitute madbeku. That is the technique. ನಿಮಗೆ ಏನ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಬರ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ನೋಡಿ. ಈಗ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಹಿಂದಿನ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್, ನನಗೆ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಅಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲ 2 ಟ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಂತ ಬರ್ಬೇಕಿತ್ತು, ಟ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಂತ ಬರ್ಬೇಕಿತ್ತು. ಸೊ ನಾನು ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಇದ್ದಲ್ಲಿ ಏನ್ ಹಾಕ್ತಿದ್ದೆ, ಟ್ಯಾನ್ ಥೀಟಾ ಅಂತ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ನೀವು ನನಗೆ ಸೈನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ಬೇಕಿತ್ತು, ಸೈನ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ. ಸೊ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ನಾನು ಸೈನ್ ಥೀಟಾ ಅಂತ ತಗೊಂಡೆ. ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ಲಿ ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಕಾಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ಪುಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಕಾಸ್ ಥೀಟಾ. ಓಕೆ, ದೋಸ್ ಯು ಹವ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಾಲ್ವ್. ಓಕೆ, theta is equal to cos inverse x. So we'll start with the LHS. So it is 2 sine inverse of, sorry. So sine inverse of 2x into square root of 1 minus x square, that is sine inverse of 2, x is cos theta, square root of 1 minus cos square theta. What is 1 minus cos square theta, students? What is 1 minus cos square theta? Sine square theta. So sine inverse of 2 cos theta into square root of sine square theta. So square and square root get cancelled. So we'll be remaining with 2 cos theta into sine theta. What is 2 cos theta into sine theta? What is 2 cos theta into sine theta? What is 2 cos theta into sine theta? 2 cos theta into sine 2 theta. That is nothing but 2 sine theta cos theta. Product is commutative. So it is sine 2 theta. So sine inverse of sine 2 theta. So that is 2 theta. So what is theta? Theta is cos inverse x. Okay, theta is cos inverse x. Okay, take the screenshot instead of, if you are finding it difficult to write, take a screenshot of it. Artha aitala, the technique is nimige en left hand side alli right hand side alli en barbeku adanne x anta tagolantadu. So x is equal to cos theta tagolantadu. Okay, so that is how you have to move forward. Okay, so if you can just try this one, if you can just try this one, 3 sin inverse x is equal to sin inverse 3x minus 4x cube. Just try this one, students. This is a homework question for tomorrow. Just try this one. Follow the same technique. Whatever you want, take it as x. Nimige en answer barbeku adan x anta tagoli, you will get the answer. And rest you have to just have to remember the formulas which we have studied in our first PUC. You will get the answer very easily. Okay, first one is this and one more is this. Two problems as homework. Take the two problems as homework, these two problems as homework questions. Okay, take the screenshot. Take the screenshot, students. Okay, I hope you have taken the screenshot. If not, those who have taken, you just send it in the group so that others also can work it out. Okay.